那华文 UCLA, I took a course on marriage counseling, and we watch a tape and analyze the couple. So the professor said, ask him, what is the ideal marriage? Say, ideal marriage, what is the ideal marriage? Is there a happy couple here? What's ideal? What is my wife? What's ideal marriage? Oh, just be short. No. You don't know how to answer? Okay. Now somebody else wants to answer. What would be an ideal marriage? About husband and wife? Yes, foster.
I don't live this, but I think that.
Okay.
So, I think that there's a model that I think is really good for marriage, which is Schnarch's model of passionate marriage, which I think is a great model. It's an integrative model.
Tell me in simple words that I understand.
I have a feeling that right now what we see a lot is our peer marriages. That's how my marriage is. It's kind of peer marriage. Kind of postmodern marriage. And then kind of going beyond that to kind of an integrative marriage. That's about the best idea that I can put
in. Okay. Now, I don't know, but this is a tough question. You and my wife can answer. But basically, the professor is trying to say...
I thought it was funny.
my specialty is to embarrass people. And embarrass myself. So everybody can laugh, okay? So the professor said, you know, most people ideal say, oh, ideal marriage means two become one. So the Bible says you, the two flesh become one. I said, oh no. That's not ideal marriage. You become one, then you lose your own uniqueness, your own personality, your individuality, your personal space, and you'll be miserable. Imagine trying to be one. That's an impossibility. That's a recipe for disaster. And what you should aim at is mutuality. And to demonstrate mutuality, he would replay the tape of the couple have an argument or a testimony. And he will say, well, what are your husband thinking when he's doing this? When we're saying that, or when he has shooting emotion, or what is feeling going on? And ask husband, what is the vibe going on? Mutuality means they understand each other. They imagine what the other person is thinking, is doing. So good relationship involves mutuality. Similarly, in therapeutic, it requires imagination to include the other person in the relationship, even though you cannot physically into his world, but imagine what he's thinking, he's doing. When there's mutuality, mutual understanding, then your guess, your imagination is pretty close to reality. So that imagination, that inclusion, is what Buber called confirmation. So you confirm other person is worthy of your ego, worthy of as a unique individual, not as client or patient or defective, you know. You accept a person as your ego, as a human being. So that is healing. You know why that's healing? Do you know why? Because every day you meet people, they either try to use you, they either to manipulate you, they either reject you or despise you. You can't appoint, you can't trust anyone anymore. How many people can you trust? When in the whole wide world that no one can trust, that no one gives you, accept you truly as the way you are and trying to relate to you in a genuine way, you feel alienated, you feel isolated, you feel marginalized. You feel displaced. You feel dehumanized. And you lose a sense of self-worth. But relationship is healing. Healing through meeting. When two human people meet each other, honestly, in a caring manner, that's therapeutic. Yeah, that's therapeutic. Furthermore, you wrestle with a patient, you struggle with a patient, sometimes you may be abused by the patient. That's why the love question. Do you love me? You love me, how you abuse me like that? Yalom say that to the patient. The patient got so mad with him, he getting close to the truth. Yalom say, we are great that we should care about each other. Now, do you love me? If you love me, how you swear at me, curse me, got so angry with me, refuse to talk to me, refuse to answer my phone call, how you do that to me? The part of the encountering. Like, how do I argue? You know, I argue with her in front of my students. Now, if husband and wife don't argue, they're not real. You know, the best way to maintain a marriage is to fight from time to time and fighting fair, right? You know, get over with, all right? So you fight with your client sometimes. You wrestle with him. You confront him. That part of healing through relationship. You're always polite. Oh, I don't want to offend my patients. You know, I don't want to upset my patients. I may lose the patients. Then you're not effective. But then you're not real. Okay? So any question? Any challenge? Don't challenge me, it's not my idea, it's Buber's idea. he's dead now, too bad. Okay, next slide. Next slide, go on. Okay, now here is his assessment, okay? I mean, right now Ryan Nimick did a piece of assessment, a positive assessment. Well, go to do it, okay? Find out about your strengths, okay? Your strengths. And there are all kinds of assessment things. Assess your personality type, assess your character strengths, and you know, use my meaning profile, assess, you know, source of meaning for your life. Assess my death attitude as well. Find out about your death attitude. Assess your coping style. They're all kinds of assessment tools, okay? But basically it's increasing self-knowledge. And that often comes from writing your life stories, journaling, okay? And telling your life story. Life review, life history.